presentation, but I may speak again my a bit out of focus. Doctor, thank you. So, thank you. I may speak my main topic, immunology and pain, but please consider that pain is a general phenomenon present always everywhere in the musculoskeletal system, and every form of pain, it means that nociceptive, purely nociceptive pain, inflammatory pain, neuropathic and central pain, starts with the same event, something, a signal, which signs that there is some danger threatening the organism integrity. And these molecules, the pathogen-associated molecular patterns, and mostly the damage-associated patterns, these induce alarmins in the natural defense system of the body, and this initiates a cascade of the pain sensation and processing. What happens at this stage? The peripheral targets where the pain signal arises are the local resident cells. So the local resident cells, the endothelial mast cells, trunk cells, and so on, and migrating cells, the stimulus of pain starts here and will be gone through the first order neuron, the nociceptive neuron, where nucleic acids, amines, factors, chemokines, and especially cytokines are induced, and they act on the receptors on the respective nociceptor neuron or other neurons, and this induces action potential through the whole nervous system. In the bone, there are specific nociceptors, meaning that free ending fibers, encapsulated fibers, these are sensing as the neighborhood. In the marrow cavity, there are peptidic sensors for pain and inflammation inducing peptides, and the same are in the periosteum. And there is a mechanical network, the network between osteocytes, which mostly forward mechanistic and piezoelectronic sensations, and this elaborated a network, and it is in connection with the primary neural network and go farther as pain sensation. Cytokines can induce pain and activation potentials in the nociceptor and other neurons via their own receptors. But again, they induce other receptors, other receptors, other mediators, which activate the peripheral neuron. And this is the same phenomenon integrated non-neuronal cells, which may be a macrophage type, or in the central nervous system, macrophage type non-neuronal cells. And all these result in activation of the pain pathway. So cytokines are all well present in the nervous system, and from the primary mesenchymal and lymphoid elements, they work on a wide variety of microglial and astrocytic cells. These are these behave as macrophages in the central nervous system also, and they connect this stimuli through the blood-brain barrier, which is open for human cells. Immunocompetent cells, as macromolecules, and in the last years, the small molecular inhibitors of the JAK, STAT, JNS kinase, STAT, K, kindness, cascade system. Therefore, these are all therapeutic targets. Another determining phenomenon in this pain processing is the central sensitization, which starts at the proximal end of the nociceptor and runs through the nervous system, through the marrow and to the brain areas also. These are energy convecting molecules, growth factors, neuropeptides as substance P at first. And here there are the molecules which they initiate. Here you see the cytokines at first, TNF, TNF, interleukin-1, and mostly interleukin-6, which is very active in the central nervous system. And here are the neuromediator mechanism, which act everywhere in the higher levels of the central nervous system. What is the explanation for the cytokines effect? That within the cell, the neural cells, through the intercellular pathways of kinin cascades, they are in crosstalk with the ion channels and potassium and so on, calcium channels, which initiate the repetitive action potentials, and those sensitize the higher order neurons and even the even the respective brain area or cortex areas. Part of this phenomenon is named as neuroinflammation. It means that astrocytes and the microglial cells behave like immune-competent cells in the central nervous system also, being present or the other cells, the immune-competent cells, crossing the blood-brain barrier, and there in the synapses induce the convection of the pain stimuli. What is the situation in the bone? That especially in the neighborhood micro-environment of the osteoclastic cells, there is a so-called acidic microinflammation, and acidity, as you know, is a primary stimulus for the pain sensation, as a proton or a hydrogen ion is the most important pain signal. This is on the pathway, as I listed earlier. And this mechanism attenuates the functional brain system and go through the cerebral networks. These networks are members of the pain processing between the cerebral nuclei and the cortex areas of the classical neural anatomic pathway. However, they reflect the functional state of the brain. And this may be imaged by several methods. These methods, the functional neuroimaging of pain, are earlier in the first line radioisotope, the SPECT and position emission tomography, PET, but the functional magnetic resonance imaging, and especially the DEFO-made blood oxygenation measurements, functional MRI, these are now in the focus of the pain research, the functional pain research. There are other on the water magnetizing, the magnetizing property of the water. There are other more modern methods, and the diffusion MRI, the tractography shows the anatomical way, the rail where the stimulus goes farther. These, the cerebral networks, there are functional pathways, I may say, in which we can follow the progression of a stimulus, a pain stimulus, within the classical brain areas implicated within the pain sensation. The default mode is that mode, or resting stage mode, where the investigative patient or person is asked to do nothing and allow their things freely move. And in this state, the spontaneous feelings at first the pain, and you will see the fatigue and anxiety. These can be visualized with the functional MRI. The other networks work during some concrete stimuli. At first, the salient mood, which the patient is asked to do the opposite, to focus. They are asked to focus anything, and the activation is measured. For example, the chronic fatigue, this network shows that these people cannot be activated in their thoughts. The others are the attention, auditory, sensory, motor, visual, and so on, elaboration. The chronic pain modifies the connections between these networks. So, for example, between the FOMO network and the salient network, and it can be located where is the pain activity present in the brain areas, cortex areas. And it was discovered that there is a great similarity of chronic nociceptive pain, as for example in rheumatoid arthritis, and the typical fibromyalgic pain, when the pain is born in the cerebral areas. The insula is the checkpoint of those pathways, and there are some similarities in the rheumatoid and fibromyalgic pain, and it results that some patients feel their pains much higher level, as it would be explained by his inflammatory state. There is another mostly psychic phenomenon, the generalized fatigue, which goes in common hand with the pain sensation and the pain and fatigue procession, which is reflected in some psychological disturbance as anxiety, depression, which are present in all chronic pain states, as it was shown. And the inflammatory cytokines play a central role in all these mechanisms. For example, adipokines are integrated also in the bone metabolism and in the psychological consequences too. So these clinical studies prove that pain, fatigue, behavioral and mood changes in chronic musculoskeletal states are generated similarly by the sensor sensitization I have presented. And this is supported by functional MRI studies. These were performed also in osteoporosis and osteoarthritis. There are some connections in synovial fluid, interleukin levels, and the cerebral signatures. And the rheumatoid trials show a decrease of this cerebral activity during the anti-cytokine and signaling inhibitor, it means JAK therapy. And this supports the earlier thought that pro-inflammatory cytokines elicit pain by an indirect way. It means that which we think that it is primary action, but this is indirect way respecting the pain sensation, but they have a direct pain-evoking opportunity, and this can be shown in the dynamics of the whole thing. This is a bit theoretical, but based on experimental studies, that the inflammation level, which explains one level of the pain, is completed by another proportion of pain, which cannot be explained by the inflammatory mechanism, and this would be this direct pain sensation, convected mostly by cytokines. And these are the proof that, for example, a JAK inhibitor kinase, baricitinib, can inhibit much more the direct pain, as, for example, the other TNF inhibitor. But more simple therapies, as, for example, ibuprofen, postoperatív analgesic ibuprofen, also affects the cerebral blood flow response, so almost every therapeutic intervention can be followed by the MRI, functional MRI method, and the most experienced method. Here you see a proof of the TNF inhibiting effect in rheumatoid arthritis patients, in the so-called responding patients, in the total brain and the different areas involved in the pain sequence, the tumulus, the somatosensory cortex became less activated during the successful anti-TNF therapy. Another aspect is, as I told, the fatigue. There is a physiological fatigue, which is an adaptive mechanism, and it is always acute, and it is improved by rest and sleep. And the subjective symptoms are the sleepiness and boredom, but there is the pathological fatigue, which arises in the cerebral elaboration of this, stress and inputs. These are physical fatigue and a mixture, a physical fatigue, a lack of motivation and mental fatigue, as for example in generalized anxiety and depression. And this whole, the extremes of this whole symptom group is the fatigue syndrome, chronic fatigue syndrome. A part of this is present in the inflammatory diseases also. This graph shows only that JAK inhibiting therapy, interleukin-6 receptor inhibiting therapy, and simple TNF inhibiting therapy all decrease the pain and a bit improve the functional ability of the patients. And this other proof, that this JAK inhibitor, this is the placebo group in this rheumatoid arthritis group, and shows that these feelings, it means that fatigue here and pain decreases very quickly within some weeks when the physical decrease of inflammation and laboratory signs of inflammation do not improve yet. So this is again an argument for the early and direct way of diminishing these symptoms. So in the future, the tractography, in which the neural tracts, the activity of neural tracts could be followed, of course, by artificial transformations. That is the future. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Professor Kodinka. Please, questions.